For each linear equation, we want to identify the slope, vertical intercept, and horizontal intercept. The vertical intercept is often called the y-intercept, and the horizontal intercept is often called the x-intercept. So for review, if we're trying to find the slope and the vertical intercept of a line, or the y-intercept of a line, given the equation of the line, we often put the equation in slope-intercept form here by solving for y, where m, the coefficient of x, is the slope of the line, and b is the y-intercept, or vertical intercept, of the line. As an example, if we consider the equation y equals 3/2 x minus 4, notice the y-intercept is negative 4. Here's the y-intercept with coordinates 0, comma, negative 4, and m, the slope of the line, is 3/2. Notice if we start at this point here and we go up 3 units, and right 2 units, the change of y is positive 3, the change of x is positive 2, verifying the slope is 3/2. But regardless of the form of the equation, if we want to find the vertical intercept or y-intercept, we can always set x equal to 0 and solve for y. The reason we set x equal to 0 is because any point on the y-axis, the x-coordinate would be 0. And then to find the x-intercept or horizontal intercept of any linear equation, we can set y equal to 0 and solve for x. Again, we set y equal to 0 because any point on the horizontal axis would have a y-coordinate of 0. So going back to our first linear equation, we had y equals negative 2x plus 5. So we should recognize this is in slope-intercept form of the form y equals mx plus b, which means the slope of the line is equal to negative 2, and the y-intercept of the line is equal to positive 5. Therefore, recording our information, the slope is negative 2, the vertical intercept or y-intercept is 5, which should be the point 0, comma 5, and now to find the horizontal intercept or x-intercept, we'll have to set y equal to 0 and solve for x. That would give us the equation 0 equals negative 2x plus 5. Solving for x, we'd subtract 5 on both sides. That would give us negative 5 equals negative 2x. Divide both sides by negative 2. And we have x equals positive 5/2, which means the x-intercept or horizontal intercept would have coordinates 5/2, comma 0. Verifying information on the graph, notice how the y-intercept or vertical intercept is the point 0, comma 5. The x-intercept or horizontal intercept is the point 5/2, comma 0. And we can see the slope is negative 2. From this point, we go down 2 units and right 1 unit, verifying the slope is negative 2. Next, we have the linear equation y equals 5x. If we want, we could write this as y equals 5x plus 0. And notice how, again, this is in slope-intercept form, or the form y equals mx plus b. Therefore, the slope of the line is positive 5. The y-intercept, or b, is equal to 0. Therefore, the vertical intercept is 0, which means the coordinates of the vertical intercept would be 0, 0. Well, 0, 0 is the origin, so if the y-intercept passes through the origin, the x-intercept would also have to pass through the origin. So the horizontal intercept, or x-intercept, is also 0, comma 0. If we didn't realize this, again, we could set y equal to 0 and solve for x. If we do this, though, notice that if I set y to 0, we have 0 equals 5x. Dividing both sides by 5, we have 0 equals x. Of course, we can verify all this fairly quickly from the graph. Notice how both the x and y-intercept is the point 0, 0 at the origin. And this line does have slope 5 from the y-intercept. If we go up 5 units and right 1 unit, we're still on the line, verifying the slope is 5. Next, we have the equation 3x minus 2y equals 10. Again, to find the slope and the y-intercept or vertical intercept, we'll start by solving this equation for y to put the equation in slope-intercept form. So we'll first subtract 3x on both sides of the equation. This would give us negative 2y equals negative 3x plus 10. And now we'll divide everything by negative 2 to solve for y. So So we have the equation y equals positive 3/2 x minus 5. Again, now the equation is in slope-intercept form. So we know the slope is equal to 3/2. The y-intercept is equal to negative 5, which would be the point 0, comma, negative 5. And again, to find the horizontal intercept or x-intercept, we'll have to set y equal to 0 and solve for x. To do this, though, let's go ahead and use the original form of the equation given here. Notice if we set y equal to 0, we'd have negative 2 times 0. This would be 0, leaving us with the equation 3x equals 10. Again, if y is 0, negative 2 times 0 would be 0, so this term simplifies out. So to solve for x, we divide both sides by 3, and we have x equals 10/3, which would be the horizontal intercept. So the horizontal intercept has coordinates 10/3, comma, 0. Next we have y equals negative 3. Whenever we have y equals a constant, we should recognize this is going to be a horizontal line, as we see graphed here. Of course, if we weren't sure, we could always make a table of values. This equation tells us that y has to be negative 3, so we can select any value for x, let's say 0 and 2. Regardless of x, y has to be negative 3. If we plot these two points, we would see this would be our line. And the slope of any horizontal line is equal to 0. Remember, the slope is the change of y divided by the change of x. But notice how regardless of the change of x on this line, the change of y, the vertical change, would always be 0. So the slope would always be 0 over some change of x, giving us a slope of 0. Next, for the vertical intercept, or the y-intercept, we can see it's going to be negative 3, which would be the point 0, negative 3. But for the horizontal or x-intercept, because the line does not cross the x-axis, there is no horizontal intercept. So for our homework, we type in DNE for does not exist. In our previous examples, to find the x-intercept, we set y equal to 0 and solve for x. Notice if we did that, we'd have the equation 0 equals negative 3, which is never true, verifying there is no x-intercept or horizontal intercept. And now for our last example, we have the linear equation x equals 4. Whenever we have a linear equation in this form, or the form x equals a constant, we have a vertical line. Again, if we weren't sure about this, we could make a table of values. Notice here the equation says x must be 4. So x is going to be 4, let's say 2 times. Because there's no y in the equation, y can be anything. If I select y equals 0 and y equals 2, both of these points still have an x-coordinate of 4, which would give us this vertical line. Vertical lines have no slope or an undefined slope. So for our homework system, we're going to type in DNE for the slope. Again, the reason the slope is undefined, because slope is equal to the change of y divided by the change of x. But in this case, notice how the change of x would be 0 all along this line, therefore we have division by 0 for any change of y. And division by 0 is undefined, therefore the slope is undefined. Next, for the vertical intercept or y-intercept, notice how there is not one, so we'll say DNE. Algebraically, to find the vertical intercept, we set x equal to 0 and solve for y. Notice if we try that, we have the equation 0 equals 4, which is never true, verifying there is no y-intercept. Next, the horizontal intercept, or x-intercept, we can see is going to be positive 4, which would be the point 4, comma, 0. Algebraically, to find the x-intercept, or horizontal intercept, we set y equal to 0 and solve for x. We'll notice there is no y in our equation, and therefore we have the equation x equals 4, which does tell us the horizontal intercept is the point 4, comma, 0. I hope you found all this helpful.